which really underscores the reality that no matter how cool we both like to believe we are, we're both huge nerds at heart. And that goes for you too. The reason I struggled with all the specifics is because those were not necessarily the most stable or lucid years of my life, which I suppose is pretty average for a 20-something in art school, except that here we are, I'm in my 30s now, and still in art school, putting all that aside, despite being somewhat directionless, I managed to stumble into what has proved to be one of the most substantive friendships that I've ever had. I think there are plenty of different ways to measure friendship. Do you have a good time? Do you get together? Do you share a passion for the same hobbies? Stuff like that. But by my estimation, there's another dimension that matters more than anything, and that's, can I be vulnerable with you? Can I reveal parts of myself that are sometimes unflattering? Can we speak candidly about aspects of life that are difficult or painful with the same ease that we joke or talk about things that are fun and enjoyable? And if I do, will you think less of me? Or distance yourself from me? Because, you know, being honest, it can be exhausting and emotionally draining to talk about and stuff sometimes. But, you know, that's what counts. Being willing to help others navigate the messy parts of life and understanding when you open up to somebody, that also gives permission for them to do the same in return. You know, someone once told me, you know who your real friends are when you have to move apartments, or in Wes's case, shops in August, and, you know, it's machinery and motorcycles and car parts, and everything is covered in motor oil. Yeah, great times, but analogies about moving and friendship are, of course, a severe oversimplification. I swear I don't have a stutter, this is really messing with me. But it feels like the point that it's easy to be there for others when everything is fine, when it's good, and you don't have to lift heavy boxes. All that being said, I can stand here in front of you all and state with absolute confidence there are few people in my life, perhaps no one, that has exhibited such excellence in this dimension of friendship as Wes. And for that, I'm tremendously grateful. And it is for that reason, Wes, as you cross this threshold with Claudine, I have no doubt you will approach all facets of what it means to be in love, to make a life together, the good and the bad, with the same sensitivity, thoughtfulness, and generosity that you've treated me with for many years. Here's to you, to friendship, and to everything you have to look forward to together.